What up, losers? It's me, Spencer, back at it again. And then I've got my dad. Say hi, Dad.
Yo, what's up? What's up? What's up? It's Headmaster. Spencer is making me do this, by the way.
You're not being held captive for this, whatever.
Yeah, I was your slave whore.
I have him in my basement.
Okay.
You made me get every scan. All right, let's get into it. Go ahead, Spencer.
Yeah.
Tell him what we're doing.
So, top 10 Naruto characters that are useless. Number one, Sakura Haruno. Sakura Haruno is pretty fucking useless. All right, am I right, boy?
Relax. Chill. You know what you should title the video? Sakura's a Chad.
That's what I'm titling it. Anyways.
Are you really?
So, yeah. So, let's get started. We're basically just doing a Sakura respect thread, but it's a video. It'll be pretty fun, honestly. Let's hop into it, you know. So, let's start off with the first important feat that Sakura has, really. That puts her above the average ninja. Or on par. Is that, the fucking proctor at the Chunin exams... It was Hayate, right? Yeah, it is Hayate.
Yeah.
Hayate says... During her fight with Ino, where they basically just punch each other in the face over and over again.
Just for like 10 minutes.
Yeah. He says, they've been going at it for 10 minutes now. And Kakashi's like, the way things are going, this could last forever. Eventually, they just KO each other, but it is a pretty good stamina feat because, as we saw, like, some people just can't go this long. I know I can't go that
Kakashi.
Long. Yeah, Kakashi.
Yeah.
Anyways,
another thing just to add, just real quick before we move on to anything else, that is a pretty cool feat, but she also like enhances her feet and her chakra.
Yeah, she basically she uses body like flicker, but like to the utmost amount.
Yeah, it was crazy.
All right, let's move on to a good feat, right? So, bell test. Yes, it's all of part one before Sakura does something all that cool. You hate to see it.
You really do.
You go for the bell test feat.
All right, well, so Sakura said she'd been training, I believe, if I remember the manga correctly. And we finally saw, you know, Naruto's grown, Sakura's grown. We finally were going to get to see what they were going to do. Kakashi was, like, pulling out his Sharingan because said he was going to be serious. And we didn't know what... We knew she was developing medical ninjutsu, one, but we didn't know what else. And all of a sudden, Sakura just punches the ground, right? And Naruto shook. Kakashi is mega shook. And it's just really bad, man.
Not to mention that she's doing this to anticipate Kakashi's headhunter jutsu. The one that he uses on Sasuke in part one. She's like, I can't see him. And she looks up behind her, to the left, to the right, and she's like, oh shit, this nigga under me. And Kakashi says, what insane power. The fifth, you didn't just teach her medical ninjutsu, did you? And it's like,
oh no.
Everyone's just shook.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the Tsunade level feat right there. The ground is just, it's just gone.
This is actually more impressive than like Tsunade attacking fucking,
Orochimaru and Kabuto.
Yeah, you hate to see it. Anyways, let's move on. So, right, next up we have the Sorcery. The Iron Sand. So, Sorcery puts this huge chunk of Iron Sand between him and Sakura. And he's like, this'll keep her away. And so she says, I'm not done yet. And just yeets that bitch at him.
Yeah. In perspective... Yeah, it's really bad, man. So, like, that Iron Sand, I've seen calcs around it, but you gotta understand, while it's not as big as someone like Gamabunta's made of, like, flesh, bone, and water. This is made out of nothing but iron. If anything, it's heavier iron soaked in poison.
Iron, bro. Iron.
Oh my god, don't do that, please. Spencer's banned from doing that.
I'm not banned
but
from doing it.
But yeah, it's like iron soaked in poison. Like, you can calc that heavier than Gamabunta, and she just, like, yeets it into a wall, and then does it the rest of the fight.
And then Sorcery's unironically just impressed.
Yeah, he started... Go ahead.
No, he was like, this girl. He's like, she for real. She about to take my life.
Yeah, if I may bring this up, like, I know people get on Dater for being the, you know, the one who gets triggered a lot, but, and people say, well, you know, Saucery let him win and shit, but dude, let me just throw this out there real quick. Saucery was monologuing the fight and getting triggered. He was literally getting to the point to where, why can I not kill these two fucking women?
Saucery is a sexist. Canceled.
Oh, God. Alright.
Alright,
let's... Next one I do want to talk about is fucking... So, we have the strongest, the quote-unquote strongest Kazekage, in my opinion, not including Gaara, right?
Not...
The third Kazekage.
Still strongest at this point, yeah.
At this point, yes. So, Saucery managed to, you know, kill him and turn him into his puppet. That's cool. This puppet then has all the weapons in the same chakra and powers. The Iron Stand World Order.
And apparently the same body, even though it looks like a puppet. No, don't let me get into that. No.
Yeah. Well, anyway. Human puppet. So, Sakura gets hit by the poison before they know about the... Or Saucery knows about the antidote. And, you know, she just one-taps it. Which, unironically, means she could probably one-tap the third Kazekage.
Not... Maybe not in speed at this point, but...
Probably not in speed, but...
Actually, I mean, Saucery took...
I'm trying to point out.
Saucery took him out, and so you have to say Saucery has relative speed, and Sakura just one-tapped it before Saucery could react and pull it away. So you could argue she has superior speed to the third Kazekage.
Yeah, but at the very least, you can say her attack potency is ridiculous.
Kage level?
Oh, no, Spencer. Don't get into that. They can't accept Kage level Sakura. Dude.
No, nope. Sakura's not Kage level. What are you talking about? All right, let's move it on.
Yeah, go ahead. All right, just go over this real quick. This is a smaller thing.
Yeah, this is just a durability feat, and it's one of the things that people say for Sakura's useless actually, but it's a pretty good durability feat. She gets smacked by a tail of the Four Tails Naruto. The same Four Tails Naruto that
almost killed Jiraiya.
Even a stronger one at that, but,
yeah,
she gets smacked by it and, like, is still conscious until, well, she's, in the anime, they say she's unconscious, even though she's not, she does hit her head, but, like, you can see that she's conscious and gripping her wound in the next panel, so, it's a good durability feat, because most people, even most shinobi would have gotten erased.
Yeah, in reference... you can see stuff like this in Bleach when people power up. But, so the four tail, the Naruto goes from three tails to four tails and knocks out, like, a mile and a bunch of earth. Like, knocking back trees all the way back towards the bridge.
It looks like a Shinra
Tensei.
Just by
transforming. Yeah.
It's just dumb.
Yeah, I'll get on to the next one.
All right.
Oh, yeah, we got a kind of a minor feat. It's just like a reaction speed feat. And that's Sakura at the Five Kage Summit reacting to Sasuke's Chidori.
Which
she doesn't do anything major. She just—it's interesting. Now I know that Chidori makes sound, and
Kari
blatantly
her,
states that Sasuke is about to do something. But the point is, she turns around and she sees it coming. That's a reaction speed feat, like by itself.
Yeah, it's pretty interesting. Like minor feat. You can say it puts her on par with the Raikage, but that's disingenuous.
Yeah, because
Sasuke
that was
doesn't
a much
have
stronger Sasuke.
That no, a this is a stronger Sasuke due to his hatred. But
well,
he doesn't
have
his Chidori. Yeah, his Sharingan, not Chidori. Anyways, let's move on. We're kind of getting through these the early stuff.
Yeah.
All right.
No.
Hey. It's my turn. So, whenever Sakura first unlocks the Yin Seal, right? You can read it. It's right to left, just like a manga. You know, we're all manga tards here. So, she punches one of the huge axe hand Jubi clones so hard that it goes flying.
Falling.
And then she literally folds this man's bro. It was bad. His body is literally flexed around where she punched him. But
yeah.
She sends it flying so hard that it knocks out other Jubi clones, and she's like, oh, we're not done here. Jumps up, and just bodies it. And in for reference, those little red dots that we have, like the little red squares, those are the big Jubi clones that we see on the next page. That's what she's just like.
Yeah, bro. So people can calc that feat and shit, and the lowest end you can get that at is like city level. Like that's an extremely absurd feat.
Yeah.
It is just ridiculous. And like even Naruto, Naruto's like, you could just say that's him, you know, usually, you know, cucking down to Sakura or whatnot, but he's genuinely like, yo,
scared
why
for
is
his
Sakura
life?
This strong? Yeah. Even Sasuke's impressed.
Sasuke, and, this is the most impressive thing we see at us. Like, the most impressed Sasuke's ever been. He goes,
bro.
Take the latter half of that, yeah.
But we should go into more detail about Hashirama's statement here and the foreshadowing. So, you want to start off with Hashirama?
So, a lot of people say that Hashirama's statement here is misinformed, right? Because Hashirama has never seen Tsunade fight. But the thing is, it's author intent. Really, that's really it. Like, Kishimoto was just so hyped about this punch. He was like, he just forgot that Hashirama didn't see Tsunade fight whatsoever. But then, like, going forward, Shizune is like, wait, she has the Byakugo seal? I couldn't do that shit. It's really funny. She's like, she's kind of peeved. And then Sakura decides she wants to throw in a snarky one-liner.
Yeah, she goes, and I don't have to waste any to maintain a youthful appearance talking about Chakra.
and about Tsunade.
Yeah. And it's important to understand here. At this next scan we have up, there are Team 7's talking to each other, and Sakura mentions, you know, maybe she'll become Kage, but that's whatever. But she says, Lady Tsunade, it looks like I finally caught up to them. Now a lot of
that
people
was,
don't
that
like
was,
that.
No, that's the next one.
Yeah.
Well, first we need to go over all the her catching up to Tsunade. Because a lot of people call it, like, oh, it's just, it was forced. She's not Tsunade level. You take that one.
I hate that. Because I've been pushing this for a while. So, Sakura, although we're not going to have everything there because they're hard to find, and English especially, but Sakura, even in, like, a part one data book, was stated she was going to become a great Kunoichi.
One of the best.
Another one says the same thing, and Shippuden in the Bell Test Kakashi says, without precise chakra control, she couldn't do that. It's a real feat. Medoka ninjutsu plus amazing strength? No, that's not all, because Sakura was originally a Genju type. I like Sorok, dude. And then he says this, she may become an even better ninja than the fifth. It's not like he's hyping her up, you know, leading her on. He monologues this to himself, so he actually believes. Into the Chiyo thing.
Yeah, I'll take Chiyo. Then Chiyo is like, agrees later, way later on. She's like, because she's sexist, but she's like, after all, a woman with a gallant spirit matching any man's is a rarity indeed. Surely you'll become a Kunoichi even greater than your master. And then she fucking dies.
Yeah. I mean, that was a really good thing for Sakura to hear. And it speaks volumes for how far Sakura came as an actual character. Because she used to be somewhat timid in stressful scenarios, like the Forest of Death. And while people meme her for this because she actually didn't admittedly do much, she grew as a person to, you know, kind of like that Naruto mentality where she doesn't want to give up. She'll get back up as much as she can. She loves her friends, cares about them, all that kind of thing. But you got to understand her love for Sasuke and all that. She is still like a 12-year-old.
She's like, she's like 12, 13 in part one. She's like 15 in Shippuden.
Yeah. And this scene with Chiyo especially, it brings a lot of emotions because oh god. Anja. But yeah, it brings up a lot of emotions because you know, Chiyo and Sakura had just defeated, you know, quote unquote defeated Sasori. And to hear that for Sakura is an important character because she's not like happy about it. She's just sad because she knows what Chiyo's doing.
Yeah. Big sad moments.
Yeah. Oh, and sorry. You want to go over the first data book statement for yeah. your the, or actually go over the scan first if that was gonna
Oh
and then
so,
I'll, and I'll, yeah.
So a lot of people are like Sakura's like, yeah, I caught up to you boys or whatever. And a lot
yeah.
A lot of people think it's like a trash thing. They're like Sakura's
yeah,
not
they
caught
just
up to Naruto
they,
fuck,
they fucking hate her, dude. And let me point this out. She's talking about them at that current they're not that's KCM 1 Naruto and base like EMS Sasuke. So she's not talking about Susanoo or KCM 2 Avatar. She's talking about their current so she's caught up to them.
Even though she might body as Susanoo. But
well, let's not talk about that.
Yeah.
So she's like I actually saw a dissection on Twitter of someone looked into the kanji and it says Okotsu. Yeah. And the kanji is to mean to, like, be even with. She is caught up to them, and she is even with them. And that's a really important thing, because a lot of people... it's like, her entire life, she's been behind them. I think he uses Rasen Shuriken, Sakura is like, oh, I'm behind Sasuke again. And she, like, takes it on herself to try and kill Sasuke. But... It was just a really touching
that
moment for Sakura's character to see like she's finally at this pinnacle. Yeah, she went from
if I may.
No one to like on par with these guys. Yeah,
yeah. If I may, man. Like I know it seems like Sakura gets his power out of nowhere. It's because I want to elaborate a little bit. Her Byakugo seal, the diamond on her forehead, when that's not there, she's pouring an absurdly large amount of chakra into her Byakugo seal
into her
for
fat
3
forehead.
Years. Yeah, into her forehead. And like this is filler, but later in like the Chunin exams where she became a Chunin, it like with Ino and Choji, I think.
Yeah.
She did struggle to even walk like long distances. So the fact that she was doing all these crazy feats before like unsuppressing herself the Byakugo seal appearing is extremely impressive. And while people may not like it, that's just how it was foreshadowed to be. And it's actually no wink right there whatsoever. That's just how it is. And
yeah, and even the data book states that Sakura had been going this entire time. Like she says, Team 7 is an irreplaceable thing that managed to get over so many hardships, and that Sakura trained and obtained strength to protect the two. She underwhelmed, like, even Tsunade in, like, the filler of where she's training with her originally. Like, she, like, Sakura, like, passes out, and Tsunade's like, yeah, we're done for the day. And Sakura's like, no, bitch, we are not. And she's like,
yeah.
let's keep it going, boy.
And if I may, that's actually not...
Is it not filler?
Pretty sure it's in the...
Okay.
But, I'll go on to the next data book statement. Well, he mentioned that one where, you know, she's caught up to them or equal to them or whatever, but there's another data book statement, which Spencer should have on screen. And it's a big-ass thing, but we have it highlighted, and I quote, Elder Shizune and grew to be the best medical ninja in Konoha in the twinkle of an eye. Now, best medical ninja. Who is the other, you know, quote-unquote, best medical ninja? Tsunade, who, you know, survived getting cut in half by Madara's perfect Susanoo.
And then
broke said Susanoo.
Yeah, broke the Susanoo. So,
the same
it's
one
pretty
who
clear.
Used Gamma Bunta's sword as her own. Gosh.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that, dude. She, like, Tsunade literally grabbed Gamma Bunta's sword, which is a hell of a lifting feat. and literally stabbed Mondo with. That was insane.
All right,
but yeah.
Do we want to? Yeah, keep going. Sorry.
Yeah, just last thing, real quick. So I understand why people, you know, they want a meme for soccer calling you useless and whatnot. But if you actually look into it and look at the context in which he was suppressed throughout Shippuden, and you're just not a soccer atard or a soccer hater, you look at it from just a non-biased perspective, you see that Sakura has this slow progression to become one of the greatest ninja of all time because of all the foreshadowing with Tsunade, of all the statements, the data books, the lore, her suppression throughout the series, beating Sorcery. These are all, like, high Kage-level feats. And this is, like, her base. She's clearly passed, like, all the Sani at this point.
Bar Orochimaru if you give him, like, Edo Tensei or something. But, well, yeah,
to
absolutely.
Be fair, yeah.
Edo Tensei's broken.
Yeah.
But let's move on to six Paz level feats, why don't we?
Alright, yeah. This is where I do want to emphasize where she does get wanked.
Oh, like an author wank?
Oh, no, never in Naruto.
What's an author wank? What are you talking about?
Oh, you mean when Madara fired a truth-seeking rod at Sakura and she can react to it?
Yeah. I mean, Obito, you know, reacts faster, obviously.
Yeah, I mean, something 8th Gate Guy couldn't do.
Yeah. Sakura has better reactions than 8th Gate Guy.
Confirmed.
Yikes.
Let's move on from... No.
Facts, you care about your feelings.
She reacts to a Rinnegan Rod. When Kishimoto draws, like, a speech bubble with an exclamation point in it, that's always what he means. It's like somebody noticed something. Or signifies
something, or
reaction.
Yep, exactly. And
you can see it in Samurai 8, too.
Although we won't show it, there's another feat where she just directly off the line charges. Ooh. She activates her Byakugo and charges at Rinnegan Six Paths Madara. And while you can use this as a speed feat, we're not trying to get too crazy with the video, but it is important to notice that they couldn't catch her in time.
Yeah, she comes from a farther distance, runs past Naruto and Sasuke. Naruto, who has threat perception from Sage
and emotional
mode
awareness.
And emotional awareness. So he should have known. And Sasuke, who has Sharingan Precog, however you want to take Sharingan Precog. Some people think it's like a movement, seeing a movement ahead into the future, like a prediction style chess grandmaster. Like, more prediction, but some people see it as, like, seeing moments into the future. Either way.
Well, yeah. She just, like, blitzes off the line, and you can use blitz their precog, but that's irrelevant because she runs at them. The anime makes this much more apparent, but in the anime, she runs, and then they run after her, but she gets to Madara, gets stabbed by a truth-seeking rod, which is an incredible durability feat. I mean,
yeah.
Like, Hashirama and Tobirama were pinned down by these and could not move.
But she
Sakura
can still
tanked
move
one,
freely and manipulate
and
her
what
chakra.
Did she do? What did she do when she got stabbed?
Punched Madara. She's been to punch that man's in the mouth. God.
Yeah, it was blocked by the Limbo Clone. But
yeah, thankfully.
Madara was still impressed, you know, reminded of Tsunade, even though it's much greater than Tsunade, Kappa. Oof. And then Naruto and Sasuke get them. So, if you want to say that's wank or whatever, that's fine. But it's noticed. And it's mainly there for that durability feat of getting stabbed by it.
Yeah, yeah.
Because they're supposed to negate chakra.
Yeah, they're supposed to, like, totally fuck up your chakra. Like, Kakashi couldn't use Chidori for a moment.
Like, even Obito... that was pains. But even Obito, he, like, permanently stopped Rigen from Edo Tensei of Minato's arm.
Yeah.
And Madara's, who's his, it must I say, at least equal to or stronger than, Sakura just tanks it and then heals. It's all absurd. Right,
but let's move on to some more six Paths level feats.
All right.
Did you
want to mention the clone thing or no?
I guess we should.
Just go over it real quick.
Obito, So Obito was talking about going through all of Kaguya's dimensions in order to find Sasuke, right? And so a clone of Naruto's like, I'll go, I'll be your chakra source. And Obito's like, yeah, buddy, that ain't gonna work. And then Sakura's like, my Byakugo chakra, would that work? And Obito's like, yeah. That Obito says, and I quote, that'll be more than enough.
Or it might be just enough, depending on which English translation you have.
Yes, he is.
But the point is, it was more than a clone of Naruto's. And to put it in perspective, a clone of Naruto was enough to defeat the third Raikage, the Deep Forest Emergence by Madara, and was instrumental in helping Gaara's division.
A single clone. In various forms.
And she has
forms.
More chakra than one clone.
In a much stronger clone, because it has six paths senjutsu.
Yeah.
Anyways, Sakura, then, later on in the Kaguya fight, you remember when the Jubi hands were coming out? Yeah, you probably should. I have it on screen.
Yeah.
Kaguya transforms into, like, this white rabbit thing. Almost cursed there. Not on my Christian channel. And so...
Yeah.
And so, Sakura bounces away and keeps running. She was still about to get hit by it, but still reacting to an attack from Kaguya is an amazing feat, however you slice it.
Yeah. It's important to realize here at this point that every character is moving faster than 8th gate guy.
Yes,
because
absolutely.
Even like base 6 bats Naruto without the KCM amp was able to blitz Madara twice, and Guy wasn't able to do that. Like, Madara was looking at every movement he did.
No, only with Night Guy was he able to do something on par with that.
No, well, he didn't even blitz him with that. He saw him coming, he's like, oh, he's bending space.
Madara was quite surprised by that. It doesn't matter, though. Yeah, let's move on.
Yeah. Hold on. I do want to bring this up real quick. I know people will try and elaborate, be like, oh, well, Kakashi saved her with his perfect Susanoo. Well, that's not the point. We know the hand
is
moving faster.
She reacted and ran away.
She saw it, she turned and was running away from it. And Naruto and Sasuke thought it was really fast. So, that's something to take into consideration.
Sasuke said, like, it's super fast. So then, the ceiling of Kaguya, right? This is something we need to elaborate on pretty well.
Yep.
Sakura drops out of Kakashi's perfect Susanoo that is now dissolving. You can say she pushes down, you can say she drops down.
She pushes down, for sure.
It really shouldn't matter. A lot of people argue the reason that she moves so fast downwards is because gravity, but remember, all of these characters are moving at speeds greatly faster than light, so the idea that gravity would have a significant, difference is very interesting.
Yeah, interesting.
In fact, Pain just jumped whenever he was hovering over the village. Like, he jumped that high, so gravity really doesn't mean much to characters of this caliber. Even weaker characters. Not that it doesn't have hold on them, but it just isn't much.
Yeah. I personally believe she propelled herself because... Should I get into the distance and time thing?
Yeah, let me get into it, and then I'll let you take Kido, some of that. Ooh, that's some juicy stuff. Sakura pushes down off of the Susanoo. At this point in time, Kaguya had already very well cleared Naruto and Sasuke's hands, who were both moving at max speed with killer intent, trying to save the world and seal Kaguya. Sakura pushes herself off of the Susanoo and literally folds that bitch.
Yeah,
oh
man.
My god.
Like,
she was
and
literally...
I do want to say that's a base Sakura, and you can interpret this like two different ways, because technically Kaguya has a Byakugan. So she had to accurately, like, dive to the correct spot. And it's... I don't want to say it's a blitz, but, like, the feat's there, and it's not an outlier. So, yeah.
So I would like to say that a lot of people just say, oh, she just swatted her on the back of the head. It's like, let me establish this. Kaguya has this thing in versus battles that we call... durability.
Oh my
and
god.
And if something isn't stronger than your durability, you don't move.
Yeah, can I give an example?
Yeah.
So Kaguya has this ability which most people call the vacuum fist. And the vacuum fist with one shot is capable of one tapping Sasuke's six pass perfect Susanoo.
Oh, let me elaborate on that actually. The vacuum fist didn't even hit him. Naruto uses a KCM arm and punches the vacuum fist, and the shockwave hits his Susanoo and breaks it.
If I may, because Spencer doesn't know the manga as well, there's also another where she literally hits it one time and it breaks. And there's another time where she hits it like three or four times and it shatters again. And she can tank her own vacuum fist, but yet she can't tank Sakura hitting her in the back of the head. So that's there if you want to go with it, though it's a reach, because you'd unironically say that she can one-tap his perfect Susanoo.
I don't know if that's a... Yeah, never mind. Let me not get into that. So let me get into like the distance
over... folded.
So everyone knows the formula for speed, distance over time, right? Naruto and Sasuke are moving at full speed towards Kaguya. Full fucking speed. There's no reason for them not to be. Any claimant for that, you come in my comments and I'll give you the Discord link, okay, buddy? And so
I'll do you on that. I'll do you on that afterwards.
Okay. And so Sakura jumps down, moves a much farther distance than Naruto and Sasuke do. They move inches and she moves like tens of feet.
Like 20, like, yeah. Like 10, 20 feet.
Yeah. And punches Kaguya so hard that Kaguya, who had already cleared Naruto and Sasuke, and she's also pretty damn tall. Like,
yeah,
I would say at least 7 feet. So, yeah. And she just folds her to the point where Naruto and Sasuke actually, like, are able to seal her again. It's just the most insane
feat. Let me put it in
feat.
Context. Let me put it in context. Let me look at this. Let me scroll back at this damn feet. So she's about 6 feet, maybe a little less, above them. She gets even higher. Sakura hits her in the top of the head, and all of a sudden, Naruto's and Sasuke's hands, who were below her entire body, are suddenly on the back of her shoulders.
She literally, like, I know we say, like, Blank got folded. No. She literally folds Kaguya like a damn towel, bro.
Yeah, okay. Dude, it is bad.
We're done wanking right. This, though. All right. Let's go to Kaido.
Yeah, Kido.
Kido, Kaido.
Anyway, so let me explain the context real quick. So Sakura has a light novel called Sakura's Story, where she goes around the lands opening medical facilities and helping...
Mental health hospitals, yeah.
Yeah, helping, like, children with mental trauma and experience, like, they experienced because of wars and stuff like that. And Sasuke is like this quote-unquote terrorist mastermind, but it's really just someone pretending to be Sasuke.
Who has his DNA.
Yeah, they have his DNA. So, the point is, they have this pseudo-tailed beast drug that enhances them exponentially, to say the least. Any, like, some of the weaker ones only have one tail, some have two. And Kido, let me put it in preference again, he's a higher up in the Anbu. I believe he's an Anbu leader, captain.
He's the new leader of Root since Donzo died.
All right. Well, the point is, he's extremely high up, about the same age as Kakashi. And Kido is kind of cocky when it comes to Kakashi, but he knows he's a serious opponent. But the point is, Kido at one point takes the tailed beast drug, and who's there to fight him? Girl in pink, the trash can herself, Sakura.
The Chad. Right?
The Chad, Sakura. And Kido grows, let's see, one, two,
not one.
Nine. Nine tails.
And for reference, most of them have, is it V1 cloaks?
Yeah, V1, two tail at most. His is a V2, nine.
It's not even V2, it's beyond that. It, like, biologically merges with him, and he has, like, a scaly exterior.
Yeah, it's like a composite nine-tailed cloak. It's really weird, but it's off the chart, man. And, do you want to read some of the stuff, or do you want me to do most of it?
So, I will. So we have two statements where Kishimoto decides to write, Kido is orders of magnitude stronger. For everyone who doesn't know what an order of magnitude is, anything multiplied by 10, that is at one order of magnitude, right? So, in one of the scans, it says several orders of magnitude faster and more destructive than what she had seen before. Just one jutsu that he lets out.
Yep.
And so, if you look up the definition of the word several, it's not one, it's not two, it's more than three. Which means that this man's lightning-style bear trap jutsu was 10,000 times faster and more destructive than before.
Yeah, and that's crazy, but an order of magnitude, one order of magnitude is 10, 2, 20, or not 20, 10, 100.
100.
3 is 1,000, 4 would be 10,000. That's how orders of magnitude work. So, no arguing against it, no countering it. It is at the absolute bare minimum 1,000 times, if not 10,000 times or strong.
Possibly 100,000, yeah.
Yeah, possibly 100,000, though that's a more reach, but it can go that high, times stronger than what he was in his base, which was an S-class, like, Anbu.
Yeah, this is fucking crazy, man.
Like, and literally, then... Sai, who... Blitzchakamaru Kappa, he wasn't confident in taking on Kido. Kakashi told him not to.
Yeah. He's Hokage at this point in time. He's like, Sai, I'm going to tell you not to do this. In fact, Kakashi thought Naruto was needed to take out Kido. And isn't that, in base?
It can be like that. I don't think so. The most you can probably get is... At the time, Kido, with this two-tail cloak, he thought Kakashi would be an enemy he could beat.
Yeah. He's like, yeah, I'll have to be a little careful, but I'll take this nigga.
Yeah, it's really bad. So, I'll get on to the next one.
Yeah.
Where she activates mitotic regeneration. So, long story short, she gets impaled by one of his tails. Right, like straight through the abdomen, like where your little belly button is, right? And she activates, she says, I won't die, ninja art, mitotic regeneration. Her entire body swells with Byakugo chakra, and the design popped in her forehead, and her cells start dividing and healing her, right? And what does she decide to do? She runs straight at him, running with the tail sliding through her body. And Kido is actually scared.
No. Let's say this. And then opens mitotic regeneration.
Yeah. She was running at him, got impaled, and kept running, activated. Kido was actually scared.
He was shook.
I would have been too. Like, really. Alright, so you want to get into the Bijudama or Sudai?
You go for it.
Alright, so basically... He fires a Biju bomb at her. It grazes like half of her body, and she's like, "Yo, that fucking hurted." But she was still standing. She got
hurted.
Yeah. And the Biju bombs were like a few meters big, I think, though more concentrated. So imagine the four-tailed Naruto Biju bomb, you know, that Orochimaru said would kill him. And I want you to multiply that by probably 4. Like five.
Five
wide and tall, and then fill a three-dimensional space. That's how big the Biju bomb was. And she tanked one, and she was still fighting him, right?
Yes.
And he tells her, you know, stop ready, condition you're in now, you won't be able to evade the next Biju bomb. He obviously does not know Sakura. He thinks that she's gonna die, right? And, point is, she, because we don't have the things on screen, I'm just going to throw this out there. This is what happens. She literally runs at him and she hits the ground hard enough to create like a thundering noise throughout the entire, I quote, the entire like Konoha forest. And, or it may have been the Konoha forest, I think. Yeah, it was, because they were visiting Neji's grave in there. And it shakes him. The Biju bomb, I'm not sure if it explodes on contact because. It fired, but we don't know where it went. So, whatever. If you want to say she tanked it, go for it. If not, it went off into space or landed on Raikage or something. Don't matter. Oh, yeah, I need to go over the regen. So, what she's been doing is she's been hitting
his... Oh, I wanted to take that one.
Oh, you want to do that? Yeah, well, hell go ahead and say it now. Go ahead
so
and say
there's
it now.
So, there's this thing called the Hayflick limit, right? It's the limit at which cells can divide. A lot of people MatPat theorized, I should say specifically, that this is what Logan was dying of in the movie Logan. So at some point, there's only so much excess cell that your cell has to use to like copy off of whenever your cells divide. And so at some point, they can no longer divide. And so what Sakura decides to do, because she's a
Chad,
is she decides, I'm going to punch him with my full power and use the Byakugo to heal him over and over and over again. And it's some after the first Bijudama, he's like, stop, you're done. You're going to die. Chill. And she's like, nah, I got a little bit more. Just a little bit more and you're done for. Kido looks at his chest and it's just falling. Like, there's a crack in his chest. And it just starts, the skin just starts to peel off and fall away in chunks.
He's just like, yo, why is this, why am I regenerating? And then Sakura's like,
because you can't.
You got fooled.
You got played, nigga.
And she goes into this whole thing about how she played him, like, what she did, she's healing him. And then, if I may, if you're done, Spencer.
Yeah.
She runs up to him, hits the ground, the Biju Bomb goes off into space or whatever, lands on Shikamaru. Not really, but whatever. It went somewhere. And
it goes into Vile's Itachi's grave, just like she would.
Wow. She hits him with the I forgot exactly what it was. It was the
Cherry Blossom Crash.
And she hits him so hard, it knocks him into I'm gonna quote Seth here, buddy. It knocks him into an entire Kido backstory because that's where it ends. Yeah. That's funny, dude. And it like fucking cucks him, and there's like thundering sounds throughout the entire forest. And she walks over to him, and he's fucking done.
He's slumped.
Like he's slumped. He's not dead, but Tail Beast Chakra gone. Him unconscious, bleeding to death. And Sakura, although low on chakra, still has enough energy to walk over to him and finish the fight. No, I don't know. I think they arrest him, but at this point, Kakashi, Naruto, Hinata, Ino, and Sai, they all show up, and they're like, oh, you did it by yourself? Wow, that's awesome. And then, it's important to note that before this, Ino and Sai were with Sakura, and Sakura was the main reason they beat, like,
two-tailed Anbu members.
And Sai and Ino were stuck fighting one or two of them, and she fought Kido. So, like...
So now
the novel is canon, by the way.
Yeah, the novel is canon, written by Masashi Kishimoto, just like what we're about to talk about, which is Boruto. Boruto era Sakura is a monster. We're only gonna go over this one feat, right?
Oh, my God. Because
my Wi-Fi is probably going to crash soon. Got 30 minutes.
Hurry up.
So, this is what she does. She comes direct. She hears that Sasuke is coming to town. And she's like, oh, I want some
Uchiha meat.
And she's running over to the tower where Sasuke and Naruto, fucking Choji's daughter, and Chocho and
Sarada
are. And... What she decides to do is you can argue she's using Chunin, like the high
body
speed
flicker.
Teleportation jutsu, body flicker. What makes Shisui so famous?
It's not teleportation. I just want to point that out.
Yeah,
it's
not actually teleportation because she has used that in combat before. But what she decides to do is she one taps Shin so hard he had to fucking perform surgery on himself. Oh my God.
Oh,
just,
my God.
And this is the
dude.
Same Shin who you can say is on par with Kinshiki because he was able to fight a suppressed Sasuke and was able to react to, like, everything Sasuke had.
Okay, before we stop this, I do want to mention, Shen caught Sasuke, like, off guard, blitzed, if you want to say that, but the point is he's relative, right? He did it twice to nerf Sasuke, to nerf Naruto, or Rusty Naruto, whatever. You know, canceled out Naruto's Kaisen, like, Fox Avatar head. And
with a sword.
That's the only reason Sakura lost, technically, quote-unquote, lost the fight, because they were in her arm. And if they can stop Naruto's fucking six-path chakra, then they can stop Sakura in base.
Also, and Sakura was told, in reference to the Shin fight, Sasuke, like, tells her, don't kill him, we need info.
Yeah. So you can argue she was holding back, but point is, she was getting pressed, and Shin then proceeds to catch a full-power Sasuke off guard again with an attack, and technically blitzed him. And
Shin's a Sakura monster, Sakura's a monster. That's what we have to say.
Yeah, Sakura is the biggest Chad in the series.
Well, and if any... Yeah, she's just a Chad.
I was gonna say, should I point, like, how strong a certain character is in, like, Shippuden compared to Sakura now?
Sure.
Yeah, so the Akatsuki are nothing to Sakura. Hashirama, he couldn't beat Sakura.
Most of Shippuden isn't beating Sakura.
Six Path Madara, not beating Sakura. Eighth Gate guy, not beating Sakura. Yeah, Kaguya, you can argue, but probably not. Alright, that's enough. Not too many people.
If you want to debate any of the claims we made, go down to the comments, ask for the Discord link.
And if I may, this was mainly a respect thread. Not a thread. Respect video for Sakura, because she is majorly, whether it's character, power, anything really, she's downplayed in the series heavily. And in the novel, she has this, like, she's higher up and people listen to her in the village, even like Shizune does and Tsunade does. She has this Hokage-like mindset where she wants to help children all over the world from mental trauma, physical trauma, and stuff like that. She's matured beyond anything I ever thought she would. And in terms of power, mindset, how smart she is, everything as a character, she is downplayed in the series. And me and Spencer just wanted to make this clear because we really love Sakura. Like, you can agree with what I said?
Yeah. We're big old Sakura-tards. And
oh, yeah.
We'll see you next time.